ZEEL is the big stock right now. So it's an index component which is gaining almost 7% in trade because of strong numbers, of course. And Mr. Punit Goenka is right here with us to discuss how the quarter fared for them. Mr. Goenka, afternoon. Thanks a lot for your time. Most of the matrices were actually ahead of what the street was estimating, though there was a one-time exceptional gain of 134 crores in the profit side. Talk to us about this part before we get to other elements.
So on the advertising front, our numbers are still a function of the market share gains that we have demonstrated on our Hindi GEC and the strong growth in the regional markets, along with our stability in the film genre as well. So it is just a function of our market gains that we have achieved, where we've been able to over-deliver on the industry.
Yes, indeed, Mr. Goenka, it's been a pretty stellar set of numbers. Tell us, what was the impact of the sale of the sports business as well on the overall revenues?
No, there is no impact on the revenue per se on the sports business sale. That is an extraordinary item.
Okay. What about your ad revenues? Because this time it's grown by about 2.9%. I'm not adjusting for the impact of the sale of the sports business. Given the fact that you've experienced the GST transition, the fact that a lot of the companies are now shifting towards digital spending, is that a concern for the company?
So from my expectation is that television will still grow healthily. The impact of digital is right now not seen on the television business yet, because it's all incremental viewership that's happening. TV is not really fallen yet. And lastly, in terms of growth, we are targeting in the rest of the second half a mid-teens kind of growth for the entire Zee network.
Right. Mr. Goenka, the other important ongoing issue in Bangladesh, what's the update on that front? Has that been also impacting your international subscription revenues, and what's the outlook overall on your subscription revenue side?
Well, the Bangladesh subscription revenue is very, very minuscule, and hence has no impact per se in a big way in our business.
And what has been the total investment in the new shows format, both on ZTV and also on the AnTV side, and how has that contributed to your overall margins? What is the kind of level would you like your margin to continue from here on?
Despite all our investments on the existing channels and new investments that we have planned for the digital platform, etc., we will be able to maintain our margins at 30% plus for the full year.
Okay, 30% plus margins for the full year. And what's your outlook on your digital spends? Is that going to be some sort of a focal point for the company or a strategy that you will look at?
We don't give that information out because it's competitive. But as I said, just to reiterate, despite all the investments in digital, we'll still deliver a margin of 30% plus.
And I'm sure the street wants to know a little bit more about the timeline and the capex for your new OTT platform, Z5, because analysts are also worried that there's a lot of competition in this segment that's picked up material, and you would need to come up with some sort of a differentiated strategy. How do you plan to address this?
So we are addressing this through a content strategy of ours. We are working on launching over the next few months our upgraded version of the OTT platform. We will be offering a breadth of content that no other player in this market can compete with, and that will be our differentiator going forward.
Thanks very much for joining us on the show, Mr. Goenka, and good luck going forward. That was a confident Mr. Goenka, management of Zee Entertainment. Index stock clocking almost 7% right now. Most of the parameters were ahead of estimate, margins slightly on the lower side, but the commentary is confident, and probably that is the reason the stock is gaining smartly in trade, both by